A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18, verses 23-35. The Unforgiving Servant. The kingdom of heaven is like this. A king decided to settle accounts with his servants. When the accounting began, a man was brought before him who owed him 10,000 talents. As the man had no means of paying the debt, the king commanded that he be sold along with his wife, children, and all his goods to repay the debt. The servant threw himself at the feet of the king and said, "Give me time and I will pay back everything to you." The king took pity on him and not only set him free, but even cancelled his debt. His servant then left the king's presence, and he met one of his companions who owed him 100 denarii. He grabbed him by the throat and began to choke him, saying, "Pay me what you owe." His companion threw himself at his feet and begged him, "Give me time and I will pay everything." The other did not agree, but sent him to prison until he should pay all his debt. The other servants saw what had happened. They were indignant, and so they went and reported everything to their lord. Then the lord summoned his servant and said, "Wicked servant, I forgave you all that you owed when you begged me. Should you not have had pity on your companion as I had pity on you?" The Lord was now angry, and he handed the servant over to be tortured until he should pay back his debt in full. Jesus added, "So will my heavenly Father do with you unless each of you sincerely forgives his brothers and his heart."
The master handed him over to the torturers or tormentors. Matthew 18, verse 23 to 34. My dear brothers and sisters, the moral of the parables is very clear. Matthew 18, verse 23 to 35 says, "This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother or sister from your heart." Jesus said, "What happened to that man will happen to you unless you learn to forgive. The tormentors will come and take you away and torture you." Who are these tormentors?
The hidden tormentors of anger and bitterness that eat us inside out. The tormentors of frustration and malice that give you and us ulcers and high blood pressure and migraine headaches and lower back pain. The tormentors that make us lie awake at night on our bed. The tormentors of an unforgiving heart that stalk our trail day and night, that never leave our side, that robs every bit of joy from our life. Tormentors that haunts, hunts and hurts us day and night and becomes our shadow.
We are like the unforgiving servant. We stand before Almighty God with our sins piled up like a mountain. The mountain is so tall that we can't get over it. So deep, we can't get under it. So wide, we can't go around it. We come as defaulters to God. We come with empty hands and say, I cannot pay. God, who is rich in mercy, replies, I forgive all your sins. My son has paid the debt. You owe me nothing. Then we go out and meet a person who has done us wrong, and we want to grasp the person by the throat and say, pay me right now.
No wonder we are so tormented. No wonder we are so angry and bitter. No wonder we have problems. No wonder our friendships don't last. No wonder we can't get along. We have never learned the secret of unlimited forgiveness. Verily, the hidden tormentors have done their work. My dear brothers and sisters, moment of forgiveness is the moment of celebration, moment of joy. Forgiveness is a power that wipes out the past, cheers up the present, and brightens the future. Today, let us ask for the grace that we may be able to forgive ourselves and others in order to enjoy the gift of life. My dear brothers and sisters, forgiveness is divine. Jesus teaches us a lesson in forgiveness through different parables. Just yesterday we heard the story of the prodigal son. Jesus has fashioned an image of God who forgives like the father of the prodigal son. Both the sons had shattered the expectations of the father. The younger son by rejecting the love of the father, and the elder son by grumbling at the father who was prodigious in his love towards the younger son. However, my dear brothers and sisters, the traumatized father shatters every expectation of the sons and behaves in a generous way, forgiving father. His forgiveness is unlimited. This generous nature of forgiving father, let us experience this today at this moment. Let us remember and recall the people who need forgiveness, whom we have to forgive. At this moment, kneel down and ask Almighty to grant us the gift of the Holy Spirit. May the Holy Spirit inspire us, encourage us, strengthen us to forgive our enemies. Let us look at Jesus in the sacrament. Our inspiration, our guru, our master, our savior. We are in the season of Lent, the season to reflect upon our sins and people who have hurt us, people who have hurt us time and again. But Jesus on the cross reminds us and inspires us to forgive these people. Let us surrender to Him and forgive those enemies. Let us make them our friends. When we make our enemies our friends, there is no more enmity and we have friends in the Lord. Jesus inspires us through various parables, and today in a special way He is inviting us. Let us look into our hearts, kneel down, cry before Him and ask Him to grant us courage to go to our enemies and say sorry, ask for forgiveness. and at the same time grant us the gift of generous heart to forgive others. In the silence of our heart, Jesus is inviting us, people who have hurt us, and people whom we have hurt. The time of Lent is a time of forgiveness, time of celebration. Jesus, in the sacrament, inspires us, accompanies us in a journey towards Him. It is He who is our Guru. He asks us to imitate Him. He invites us to unlimited forgiveness. 70 times 7, unlimited forgiveness. That is the madness of mathematics. There is no count. It's unlimited forgiveness. Jesus in the sacrament, look at Him. He's present. He's with us, accompanying us, journeying with us. Let us remain quiet for a moment and gather the courage and strength from the Blessed Sacrament.
My dear beloved sisters and brothers who are joining us in this beautiful adoration, Ignite Lenten Evening Adoration, We do not know where you are joining from, but we do know that you and we are connected with one Christ in one mind and heart. In that sacred heart of Christ, we are united as one body, one flesh in Christ. Today we especially pray for these youngsters who have come all the way from their homes, from St. Peter's Church Parish at Bandra. We like to pray for each of them, their parents, their siblings, the parish priest, Father Fraser, the other fathers, Father Assis, for Sister Jenny who is here. May they become, Lord, a magnet to attract thousands of youngsters to your sacred Eucharist. Lord Jesus, we offer you all the pains and sufferings of your holy people. Lord, too many of them have called or sent SMSs or sending prayer petitions on YouTube or Facebook, Lord. You alone can count them, Lord, in your mighty name, Jesus. In your holy love, Lord, listen and answer to all their prayers and petitions. All those who are suffering from physical pain, physical illness, mental pain, depression, various other difficulties at home, in offices, situations, problems related to properties, misunderstandings, brokenness in marriage, estrangement of beloved ones and fathers and mothers, children being aborted, very especially the people suffering in Ukraine, especially for Putin and his team members to have a change of mind. Lord, we entrust all these prayers and petitions at your feet on this holy altar, together with these thousands of people of God gathered here. We make this prayer in your mighty name, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let's all kneel before the Lord for the benediction and final blessings. Let us bow in adoration.
All the old must still Blessed be God. Blessed be His holy name. Blessed be Jesus, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be His most sacred heart. Blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be Great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in His angels and in His saints.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving.
My dear beloved sisters and brothers of the St. Paul's Multimedia Adoration Global Eucharistic Family, we thank you so much for joining in this beautiful Adoration Lenten Evenings with the Lord, the Igniter. We especially thank the youth of St. Peter's Church who have come here with Father Ashish Rodriguez, the Assistant Parish Priest, and Sister Jenny. May I call Father and Sister be here along with your youth, Calista D'Souza, Grisel, Joshua, Deanne, Grisel, Divino, and Bavian Fernandez. Kindly come forward before the altar. Come. So these are the youth who ignited us with their beautiful thought on forgiveness, God's abundant forgiveness. Thank you, Father Ashish, for preparing this youth as a magnet to catch hold of so many other people of God across the world. Thank you, Sister Jenny, and everyone. Give a love to your parents, and may many, many more youth come to the Eucharistic Lord through this Igniter. Thank you so much. And dear friends, an announcement to you all. As we used to announce, there is a beautiful week of retreat called Ignite Your Life Retreat from 4th to 10th, a week before the Holy Week, happening right here online from 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock every evening. Kindly note the date. Selected preachers are lined up, including Bishop John Rodriguez. Don't miss it. God bless you. See you again for tomorrow's Ignite. Good night.